Thank you. pixels. How are you all doing? This is Rena TV Live. I'm back and I'm even more nervous. Ah! Is the sound okay? Can you hear me? I know last time I had trouble with sound coming out of one ear. Is it coming out of both ears now? At least it is. Hi. Can you hear it? Okay, good. Yeah? Oh, you guys aren't answering my questions. Be helpful. Okay, good. Thank you. yeah, welcome. This is second episode of Rena TV Live. Today, we had so many requests to do a Rena EP listening party after last week's insane So I'm listening party. I hope you caught it. If you didn't, we'll leave it in the description below so you can see that. But yeah, hi. Oh, God. How is everyone doing? I firstly want to know where you guys are all tuning in from. So, like, tell me your, like, country and city. It always makes me really happy. Yay. I did my hair really cute, like, buns on the side. And then I completely forgot that I have to put headphones on. So it's, like, squished now. Hey, where are you guys from? Toronto, Portugal, Philippines, Chicago, Nihon, Connecticut, San Francisco, Italy, Pennsylvania, yeah, London, yay, Brooklyn, oh my God, yay, thank you so much, guys. I'm so excited to be with you again. Yeah, how is everyone doing? Oh yeah, also happy Mother's Day if you are living in America. Yeah, I hope you're able to see your parents or your mum. Like, it kind of makes me really sad because my mum lives in Japan, so I don't know when I'm gonna next see her, but yeah, luckily technology and stuff like this. I think she might be watching, but anyway, hi mum, if you're here. Yeah, how is everyone doing? This week I was feeling a little anxious. I don't know. Oh, I think, like, lockdown in the UK got extended for 3 weeks. And I don't know, like, my anxiety, like, kind of has been weirdly better during the lockdown. And yeah, I don't know, like, it's kind of flared up a bit. So I don't know if you guys have anxiety, like, I hope you're doing okay. But yeah. Love you guys very much. Okay, I've got some questions. I tweeted and told you guys to tweet your questions to hashtag Rena Listening Party, and you guys sent it in. So I've picked some of my faves. Okay, let me try this. Here we go. Also, lol, this is like the live version of Take Me As I Am with the dance break. Oh my God, I don't know if I can remember that dance break. Anyway, first question. Okay, are we getting a re-release of Rena EP and vinyl? This is like the most asked question. I had to, like, go and find this. I just could not find it, but I found it. Look at her. Oh, bless. Actually, funnily enough, the logo at that time was, like, Pixel did it. And we contacted them. We were like, hi, can we, like, buy it off you? And yeah, they agreed, so thank you. But yeah, this one is like yellow, like buttercup yellow. How fun. Okay, I have an answer question. So we obviously right now, strange and unprecedented times, we're having a bit of trouble making new presses. So obviously we're constantly working to press Sawayama, and you guys have been selling it out. Last week on Friday, like, I chased my team. I was like, guys, why is the Sawayama vinyl not up? You told me that it'll be up on Friday and it's not up yet. And people are asking me, like, always tweeting me. And then they were like, yeah, we put it up this morning and it sold out like that. And so, yeah, you guys in your thousands are going nuts over it. Again, I haven't asked the question. Okay, so basically it will be repressed. It will be repressed. Repressed? Repressed. But it'll be soon. It'll be this year. It'll be within this year. That's all I can say. I don't want to promise anything because I think they manufacture these in Belgium or something. So it's a bit hard with like sending stuff over. Luckily when Sawayama was made, it was like, you know, I think I submitted the master like in December or January. So we had like a bit of time, but yeah, if we're going to like do something now, it's a bit like, ah, but yeah, I know I hear it so much. And I really want to. And actually I used to send that out like from my kitchen. and like from the store. So at the beginning I used to like pack and ship everything. So if you got that, you probably got some of my lovely hand sweat on there, so very lucky. Okay, cool. Next question. Everything. Oh yeah, I haven't fixed the delay because I fixed it and then there's some sort of other problem with crackling. I don't know if there is a really like nerdy pixel. Me, Hannah and Chester were on Zoom last night trying to sort it out for like an hour. Just, yeah, what a blow. Yes, I will be pressing. This is the YouTube chat, by the way. I'm just like looking down, sorry. Yeah, hand sweat. I've got some serious hand sweat. I think I'm like sweating now. I don't know. I've never had BO, but like I have hand sweat. Anyway, okay. Okay. Sen? Does that work? Oh, okay, cool. So this didn't really fit in the frame. Okay, the album was about the security of being online and sharing emotions through the screen. Where did the inspiration come from? Well, I was just like so anxious. Oh my god, we've had our first super chat. Thank you so much. Oh yeah, guys, sorry. Before I answer the question, we've got super chat turned on today. So if you want to support this channel and support just like more content, more stuff like this, yeah, hit super chat. It's like, I've never actually done it, but I think it's like a thing. And yeah, so I'm going to read some super chat questions before they disappear. Oh my god, stress. I've never done this. Do they disappear? Oh no, they're still there. Okay, so I'll read them in a second. Sorry, I'll definitely read them. Whoa, I'm not good. Okay, hang on, one sec. The inspiration. Yes, okay, so I was really feeling anxious and this was like maybe in 2014. And I was just constantly comparing myself to other people that I followed on Instagram and Twitter. And I was like, I'm not good enough. I'm never gonna be good enough. My music's shit, everything's shit. And I was like really suffering from depression and anxiety at that time, so. Yeah, I kind of like distilled all of it and wrote this record because I was just like, I want to write like music that I kind of want to. And yeah, you guys loved it. So yeah, I was just kind of writing about the things that were happening around me, I think. So yeah, that's my inspiration. Okay, I'm going to read the super chats now though. Pedro Gomez, thank you so much for your super chat. Much love from Brazil. Yeah, I love Brazil. When are you going to sing song from So I Am Alive? As soon as I can. As soon as I can leave and come to Brazil. Finally. Marcelo, I love you so much. To Nello, I love you too. Thank you so much for your super chats. Well, this is fun. Okay, wait, I might just... So I'm above the question. Okay, here we go. Okay, which song from the EP am I most proud of lyrically? I think CSS still, because I think I told a really good story there and I love telling a story. Like, I kind of wrote it about my friend. It wasn't like directly like about her, but it was kind of, you know, I was thinking about what she would do in a situation like that, and yeah, I think that, you know, girl in the corner stirring her soda, batting the shit out of her straw. Back then all straws were plastic, so you could do that. No, I'm kidding. But yeah, so I kind of love telling a story and I feel like that's really hard to do, try and fit it into like a sentence or a verse. So yeah. Oh my god, so many super chats. Wow. Ah, thank you. Okay, hang on. I don't know how to bring super chats into the screen yet, so I'm just going to read them out. Here we go. Can we talk about how you put this Final Fantasy Victory theme in Snakeskin? Well, look, that is Sawayama related. It's not this EP related, but I want to say that in CSS, there is also another Final Fantasy sample. Not sample, I don't want to say sample, it's not sample. It is inspiration at the end, I think. I'm pretty sure. I think it's like the interlude music. You know when you like start the game? I don't know what it's called. Anyway. Can I do a signing at Rough Trade when this lockdown is over? Hell yeah. I've been signing so many posters from home, guys. So if you find any like crisps or something in there, that is just me, just being myself. but yeah, I would love to do signings. I want to see you guys. I haven't seen you guys since the tour in like 2018. I was just thinking, like, I didn't go on tour in 2019. So yeah. Will there be any new dance breaks on tour? Okay, so this is appropriate because, yeah, this song is Hit Me As I Am live version and it has dance breaks. I was watching videos of me doing it for the first time. I was dying. Oh, God, why did I do that? Sometimes, like, my dreams and my expectations are, like, here. Like, here. And then, like, my ability to do them is, like, here. And then I hope that on tour it will kind of climb its way up here. But, yeah, I think, like, I did the dance break to Take Me As I Am, like, well at the O2. But before then, I think it was a mess, I'm not gonna lie. love the Britney influence in my music. Thank you. What's my favorite song of Britney's? Ooh. Oh my God, that is such a hard question. It, like, changes every day. I think Toxic is legendary. But also Don't Let Me Be the Last to Know from the, I think it's the first album. Apparently that was written by Shania Twain. Legendary. We cannot. You guys are asking non-Rena questions. This is not fair. I love you so much. Thank you, Rodrigo. Thank you, Louise, for that question about the dance break. That question about Britney with Cinema 101. Thank you. Yes, Rena Supremacy. Am I allowed to say that? I feel kind of weird. Anyway, thank you, Nalia. Patrick, for that question. The Rough Trade. Let me see. Thank you for your comments about Sayama merch, Alicia. Love the new Sayama merch. Definitely wearing to the Toronto show. Yay, Toronto! I love Toronto. I don't want to sound basic, but I had my first poutine then and it was so good. And we went to a mall in Toronto. Okay, like, Brits get really excited about malls because we don't have, like, we got like Westfield and stuff in London, but it's just like a different level in North America. Where did I get the inspiration for the designs of the new merch? Okay, so the new merch, I'm not wearing it today, damn it, is by these three people, Umru, Max and Eden, and their own parent company. They also run Open Pit, I think, which is where I did the Minecraft party the other day. But yeah, I was just like, go Maximal, Vampire Hunter D, boom. And they did it all. I don't want to take any credit. I kind of just look over and I'm like, perfect, looks great, let's do it. But yeah, I'm so glad you're loving it. The Sawayama album sweatshirt has been going like crazy, guys. Raseem, I love you too, thank you. Marcelo, thank you, I love you. Michael, have you been to Ireland? I've never been to Ireland. I know, that's so bad. I'm so not well traveled in my own country. Great Britain, Ireland, I've just never, it's bad. I know. Yeah, I need to fix that. Will I add Russia to the Sawayama tour? I would love to. Guys, I want to do a world tour, but we have had to just kind of stay put and just hope that things are gonna subside. Like, we've got contingency plans for everything, and my live agents, shout out to Paradigm, even though things are really tough for the live agents right now, they're really like doing their best, so yeah. Thank you, Paulina, for that question. Thank you, Michael, for the question about Ireland. Mateus, I love you, yes, and Stream Sima, yeah. Dawson, thank you so much for your super chat. What albums have you been a big inspiration for Sima and Rena? What am I doing during this time? I'm being anxious during this time, babes. But I'm actually, the anxiety is quite a recent thing, but I've actually been kind of thriving in lockdown. Very thankful that I am well enough to do that. I know that I'm very privileged. I've been kind of working on this and this all this visuals and the live stream. So I'm glad you love it.
Hi.
All right, I'm going to take a minute to go back to the questions that were sent from you guys. Oh my God, I did not realize Super Chats would get this lit, guys. Thank you so much. Okay, cool. I don't know if I can ask a question, but I'm just going to try anyway. Here we go. Mateus, it's you again. Is there any song that wasn't supposed to be on Rena but ended up on it anyway? Just like Love Me from Me. I'm sorry, by the way, Beatrice Rena for you for not including it. Oh my God, Justice for Love Me for Me. Yeah, last week I said that I kind of wanted to not have that on the record. But like, I'm grateful that it's on there. You know what? 10/20/40 never made it on there, and you guys are going to kill me. You're going to be like, you bitch, you have no taste. Yeah, because I just felt like I couldn't nail it. And basically at that time, you can probably hear from my songs that I really wasn't comfortable with like gaps in sentences, like in the structure of the song. And like, just the, like, I thought that like having one bar gap in the chorus was just like too stressful. So, I don't even remember the lyrics. Okay. Little white pill keeps breaking and entering my body and mind. That gap after, I was like, Clarence, we need to fill that gap. And he was just like, why do we need to fill that gap? We don't need to fill that gap. And I was like, we need to fill that gap, otherwise it's not going on. And luckily, again, him and my team intervened and they were like, okay, you need to calm down. That gap is fine. Like, it's called an instrumental gap and it's fine. Like, all your songs don't need to be so wordy. Just shut up. So I'm glad I listened to them because it's a bop and that guitar riff is sickening. All right, oh my gosh, more super chats. Wow! What's my favorite song at the moment? Love from Finland. Thank you, Nido Panda. Oh my God, what is my favorite song at the moment? Mood. Oh my God, it's so hard to think of songs. Oh God, I want to say something really cool. Oh my God, Superstar by Jamelia. Superstar by Jamelia. I love my own playlist, guys. By the way, I do playlists for all my singles. Actually, I haven't done one for one of them, I think. I didn't do one for Chosen Valley, but I did one for each single on Spotify. Sorry, Apple Music users, but it's like kind of a bit more tricky to do playlists on there than it is on Spotify. But I made like inspired playlists. So I've been listening to, I think it was XS or Comme des Garçons playlist, and Jamelia was on there. We absolutely have no choice but to stan Superstar by Jamelia. Oh, this is a good question. Terrence Freeze, thank you for your question. How many non-Sawayama songs are you singing on tour? Cherry, Tame Yazayama, and CSS. This is something I kind of want to ask you guys because basically the album is 45 minutes and my set can't be longer than an hour. And like thinking about like, you know, like extended mixes of the songs, outfit changes of the songs, like it really like just performing the album, the new album takes it up to about an hour. So I really need to be like quite picky. I think I'll be doing like little medleys with it. But yeah. Let me know. Obviously, Cherry. I will play Cherry. But let me know. I don't know how to say your name. Sorry. NV. Thank you. Rena was so good with my new headphones. Yeah. I need new headphones. Like, it's like the plastic, the leather is not. Like, anyway. Will you be coming to Norway when the lockdown is over? Oh my God. I used to see someone who was Norwegian, so I was going to Norway quite a bit. I used to go to Trondheim and go to the fjords, and it was absolutely beautiful. I would absolutely love to. Ellie, Fletcher, Westfields is toss. I love Westfields. It's like right very near like a studio space that we use a lot, and I end up there and I get boba. Anyway. Thank you, Josh Australia. How come Play On Me never made it onto Rena? And will it ever come out officially? You guys didn't vote for it, but I feel like maybe you guys didn't vote for it on Twitter for it to be played today because you don't know what it is. Basically, Play On Me was a song that I wrote with Clarence for a Mac commercial, and it kind of popped off. Like, it almost popped off too much for it not to be like an official release. But yeah, I mean, I've got it queued up, but you guys didn't vote for it, so. Thank you, Sam. I love you. Sam Rexworthy, thank you so much. Oh my God, your username is crazy. 12345. BBBBB 12345. Much love to you. I love you, Philippines. Thank you so much. I know Pixels are a wonderful community. You guys are so supportive. No mean comments. We don't need to be mean. Melanin, stop playing. Thank you so much. That is so sweet of you. Thank you for listening to the album every day. Wow. Epitome of sass. Yes. Oh my God. Upset. Oh my God. I can't wait to see you in Boston. Yay. VIP. Yes. Who's got VIP? Type VIP if you've got VIP. Thank you for mentioning the video for Ordinary Superstar, the Epitome Sass. That one got forgotten. I swear to God, I have got it. I've got it as a little visual for later. But yeah, Justice for Ordinary Superstar video. I think it doesn't. I don't even think it has like 500,000 views. What a blow! What a savage blow! She deserves better. Okay, Jordan Bayer, thank you so much. What is an HQ? Oh my God, I'm such a boomer. Haiku? Okay, Robert Yoshida. Oh my gosh. Yeah, 19-year-old man. Oh my God, that's so sweet. Thank you. That's not weird at all. Anyone can love my music. I looked at my Spotify like insights. I like hardly ever do that, but I like went on it. And yes, 40 to 59-year-olds are popping off on Sawayama streams. Thank you. So it's not weird at all that you're 19-year-old Marine. We all come from different walks of life, different places. It's all good. It's lovely. Collab with Biba Doobie. I like a lot of things. Thank you. I love Biba Doobie. Pedro. When am I coming to Brazil? I don't know. When is it? Have a word with Miss Rona, please. I would love to come to Brazil. I'd love to come to South America in general. I've never been, so. Am I planning to get new tattoos? Yeah. I want to get more, but I've kind of, guys, like, if you ever want to get tattoos, just chill out on the arms because, like, you quickly run out of space. But yeah, there's some. I got a cicada, like, kind of fairly recent. Oh my God. Because it reminds me of Japanese summers. Yeah, a lot of my are by an artist called Tati Compton, who I absolutely love. So, yes. I mean, if you oh, no. Let me know if you want me to do, like, a, what the hell is it called? Oh my God, my mind's gone blank. Oh, a tattoo video for Rena TV. I don't know. Is that a bit like... Yes, send Justice for Sleeping and Waking. Call me mom. Oh, I hope you have the best day ever. That's so sweet. Thank you, Sujana. Rodrigo, thank you. Yes, you know what? CSS... Was the CSS abbreviation intentional? Cascading style sheets is how websites are styled. If it's the thing. Yeah, I know. So, it was a coincidence. I want to say it's divine intervention, but it was a complete coincidence. But yeah, CSS being part of that is pretty cool. That doesn't make any sense. Sorry. I'm just, okay, so basically my computer, because you guys are like blowing up the charts, like is going a bit like, but 1 second. Okay. Okay, I think is that the bottom of it? Oh my God, you guys have been so generous with your super chats. Thank you so much. Oh my gosh, I really hope that you're enjoying the content that we're making for Rena TV. Like, I really wanted to do this because first of all, I love YouTube. Like, I just don't even watch TV, I just watch YouTube. And I think it's such an amazing platform to like actually connect and chat with you guys. And I wanted to like narrate the behind the scenes rather than just like show you like really cool like footage and then that's it. Like I was just seeing so many of those. So I wanted to do something a bit differently and do like narration and kind of present the thing. Some people were like, oh, are you sure? Like, you're like, you want to be like a YouTuber? And I was like, yeah, no, I think it's sick. Like, I think people are not taking like stock of this amazing platform. But anyway, so yeah, thank you for supporting the channel with your super chats. Really appreciate it. Shall we go into playing the record? There's so many. Oh my gosh. Let me, okay, I'm gonna do 5 more super chats and then I'm gonna do the record. Give the girls what they want. Okay, here we go. Oh my god, I got an, yeah, okay, so sorry. Make note of it. Thank you so much for your super chat. And also thank you, Dawson Cleverly, as well, for your super chat. Ah, I'm obsessed with you, thank you. Make note of it. Yeah, I was supposed to be singing in Boston yesterday and scream singing CSS, love you. I got a notification from BA, who I was going to fly with, saying, your check-in for the flight to London is now open. I was like, well, that's good. Thanks. Yeah, I'm really sad. So the North American tour would have been finished and I think I would have been starting to do Glasgow tomorrow or something, or a couple of days' time. What a blow. It's fine though. I'll be back. Jostria, Pixels, hashtag justice for ordinary superstar. Let's get the video to 1 million views after the stream. Yes, please do it. It really deserves better. You know what? I might do a video playlist of all the Rena videos underneath this video so you can watch it. Wonderful. What's the tattoo on your left hand, says Michael M. That's my left hand. This is a vortex. I watched Interstellar and got a tattoo like a fucking basic bitch. But I really love that film. Me and Ravina were talking about it. We were like obsessed with Interstellar. It's like, it's fine. Oh, and this one is a picture by Ren Hang, who is an Asian photographer who sadly passed away. He was like 27 when he passed away. I can't really get it to focus. Oh my God. The YouTuber style. There we go. It's 3 naked ladies, and I think Ren's like portrayal of like, or just photographs of Asian women are just amazing, so I would go check out his work, Ren Hang. Cool. RJ McKenna, I've never heard of a band called Crying, sorry, should I check them out? Nalia, are you gonna make a Twitch soon? Yeah, do you think I should make a Twitch? I don't know, I feel like there's a little community here. I'm like, would you guys come with me, or like what's happening? I don't know, I feel like Twitch is maybe more chill and I could do like gaming and stuff. Me and Hannah were talking about playing Sims. So let me know if you want to see that, because I've never played Sims in my whole life. So I was like, and Hannah's played it before, so we were like, let's do it. It'd be quite jokes. And I watch people like Plumbella, who is hilarious. And Juno Birch, who does like these sim streams. I don't think I'll be as funny as them, but like we'll try. Yeah, Marty Cooper, did I play the Final Fantasy VII remake? Okay, yes, I've been playing it, and I think I'm on chapter 9 or something. The big event has happened. Yes, I don't want to spoil it for anyone because it's actually so good. I would really recommend you guys switch it to Japanese though, the audio, because the dubbing is, it's not about, like, it's really hard. I know it's hard to do dubbing for Japanese stuff because I think they have to like, it's called like mouth flap or something, where they have to like match what the Japanese is in the script, in the English script. So even if the Japanese is like really short, like, or really long, like they have to match that in English and it like makes no sense. So I would recommend you like hear it in Japanese and then have the subtitles underneath. Yeah, it's sick. James can read. This is a shameless plug to try and get my GA tickets upgraded to VIP for Chicago. Oh my God, babes, why did, like, can you, is this sold out? Is that why? I feel really bad because I literally don't know how to do that. Babes, don't put me in an awkward position. But I really appreciate that. I don't know if the VIP is sold out. I think it is. I know LA is definitely completely sold out. Paulina, do I know Girls' Generation? Would I like to cut? Yeah, Tiffany Young's kind of sick, you know. I was following Girls' Generation when G was blowing up back in the day. I think it was like 2009 or something. I was obsessed with that song. But anyway. Cool. I'm going to start doing the thing now. Wait. I can't talk. Do you guys find that like during this lockdown, because you're just like not using your brain, like the social side of your brain as much, that you can't talk? I can't talk. This is brain stimulation for me, guys. You're really like helping me out. Thank you. Wonderful. Okay, cool. Okay, how do I do this? Oh my God, I've literally forgotten. Okay, we're gonna go into intermission and then we will be back to do the Rena EP stream. Bye. We'll be right back.
single day.
And we are back. How are you all doing? Eating okay? I'm not taking a poop. I'm seeing what you're writing. Alright. Shall I start? I feel like I should start. Okay, I'm going to do three more super chats and I'm going to start. Alan, thank you. How hard was it to do the high notes in Dynasty? Actually, not that hard. Gonna be harder to do on stage because the conditions are not like the studio. You're like your adrenaline and everything, like your throat just constricts, like, so to hit those high notes you just gotta really like hit them. It's a whistle note kind of a little bit below that, so it's a bit tricky, but it's gonna be fine. How do I deal with procrastination in uni? Oh my god, I'm not the right person to ask, but I was like seriously procrastinating. I couldn't do the work. I would say if you guys have a problem procrastinating, I would say find out how you're gonna do that. Break it down. Be like, okay, Google whatever this is. Click on this. Collect 5 sources. La la la. Like break it down, and then find how you're gonna do it, and then why you're doing it. That should sort it. All right, let's go in. We might be turning off Super Chats while we are doing the album streaming, just so we can focus and have crazy times. Okay, cool. Sweet. Let's go to the first song, which is... Yes, it's hashtag justice for ordinary superstar. You know, I song. I think I was inspired by YouTubers actually, because I was like amazed that these like really normal people who were like working really hard were basically superstars. like, look at Nicki Tutorial, look at Jeffree Star, all these huge people. But it's just like, where does the relatability finish and where does it end? Screen, you're a queen, but you're living in the cloud where there's no rain. But like, I spelt rain like the reign of a king. Ooh, I thought I was talking about. Okay, and this is the video that I was talking about, Justice for Ordinary Superstar video. You guys can, we're gonna leave a link below, so make sure you catch it. So this video was actually styled by Nicola Formichetti, which is like the craziest thing ever. Obviously you guys know who Nicola Formichetti is. If you're a fan of Gaga, you know who he is. He literally DM'd me like in 2018 when he was obsessed with Take Me As I Am and Alter Life and was like, I'm gonna make you the Asian Gaga, is what he said on Instagram DM. And I died, and then so he styled my video. Yeah, been a supporter since. I love you, Nicola. Shouted him out in Comme des Garçons afterwards. Fun fact, this was like an all-star lineup, this video, which is why Justice for Ordinary Superstar video. It was Danielle Polanco who choreographed it as well, who I'm terrified of because she's like huge name. She did Finesse video. She's in the Finesse video. She did Dance For You video by Beyonce. Like, I don't know. If you know Danielle Polanco, you know Danielle Polanco. Anyway, she came in, like coached me for 2 hours and then she had another job. So she had to leave. So we had like had her for like half a day and She was like, you need to bevel your feet. And I was like, ah, she's from New York, I think. I don't know. But she like had this like very like straightforward New York talking vibe. And I was like, I'm terrified. Ah. But yeah. So cool. Yeah. So this video was shot in New York. And it was shot, like we put it together in like 3 days. I don't know how. There is this amazing karaoke in Flushing, which literally looks like that. And I wanted to do male drag in Japan. What is it called? Oh my god, it's literally slipped my head what it's called. What is male drag in Japan, guys? Oh my god, it's like a whole thing. My brain. Nihon no minasan, nan dakke? Nihon no male nano, nan dakke? 女性がダンスをする drag. Oh my god, I'm so dumb. Okay, whatever. Anyway, so my brain. No, it's not kabuki. It's Takarazuka. Yeah, Takarazuka drag. And so I dressed up in that, and then it was like inspired by like the 80s before there was a huge financial crash in Japan in the 90s. Actually, probably the year after I was born. So I wanted to kind of like show that vibe. And there's amazing queer Asian people from New York are in the video. So thank you so much for being in the video. What a fun little moment. Cool. I forgot to read some super chats. Thank you, Dimitri. Thank you, Kay. Yes, we need a collab with Bree Runway. We'd love it for XS. We love Ravina. Absolutely love Ravina. I did a fun thing with her for the fader if you want to go check it out. Thank you, Kev. Cool. Yeah, we have turned off super chats for the minute because it was getting really chaotic, but like, obviously, thank you. cool. I have not listened to this EP in like years, like since I think I finished doing the tour. Madness. Okay, so we've been having this running in the background for the whole time, but this is the legend, the icon, Take Me As I Am. Every single day. Facts about Take Me As I Am, which I don't think I've ever revealed before. So I think this was the song that Clarence Clarity sent to Anthony Fantano, and then Anthony Fantano was like, what is this? And then decided to check it out. But you know what? I'm not gonna brag, but I'm just gonna let you know that this little tiny EP, 8 tracks, 2 interludes, actually got some cute reviews back in 2017. And this is, I'm so grateful, because Pixels, Day One Pixels, if you've been there, you know, it's been a long journey. But yeah, this is Line of Best Fit. Oh, look at the visuals. Is it 8.5? I think. Yeah, we love to see it. We have The Guardian, gave it 4 out of 5, which is stunning. And then, yeah, so Needledrop gave this a 9, this EP, which is what really helped, get the record out there, I guess. So I'm really grateful to The Melon. Thanks, The Melon. And I'm really grateful for you guys and supporting me, because back in the day, so I did this whole record independently, and that is so hard. Like, I remember just like doing a music video is so expensive, and there's like no way that someone can like save that up themselves, or they've got to be like in a city where they've got to have friends or connections who can like help you out. And like, yeah, like, so I actually got asked a question about any, hang on, I have a question. When, let me get it up. Oh, I can't find it. There was a question about how you get started. And honestly, like, I would say work a different job at the same time at the beginning, which is like the most boring thing. But I worked like 3 jobs on the side, and that is genuinely how I could afford to be independent. Because sometimes if you like have no money, and then you're like trying to get signed, and then you might not sign a really great deal. And yeah, like the signing bit to me was kind of because I was working so hard and I was saving up my own money. I was like, okay, I can like kind of wait till I get signed. But yeah, that is the advice I would give producers or, you know, musicians or any creatives. I would say, you know, you can get so many amazing life experience as well from working different jobs. I loved the part-time jobs I had because I could have easily hated them. They weren't great. They were like retail. I had to like clean off literal like nail fungus from people's toes, and I could have hated it, but I loved it because I was like, this is leading to my dream and I was meeting some amazing people. So some fun advice. But oh, another little tea for Take Me As I Am is that we nearly had a full-blown video for this, but it fell through, and it was going to be a video with Nicola Formichetti again, but yeah, did not work out. So many videos fall through, just loads of different things, like schedules don't match, budget, mostly budget actually, and back in the day, again, like I said, independent, you know. And I'm grateful for the brands that supported us, like the CSS video was Vinyl Factory, and the Vinyl Factory, and yeah, Ordinary Superstar was supported by ID, so super grateful for everyone who supported me. Cool, next song is the one. justice for her. This is 10 2040. Questions about what this song is about, and it's like dosages basically. There was a time where I was taking citalopram, so I had really bad depression, and I quickly went from 10 milligrams to 20, and then the next one was 40, and I remember feeling like, oh, I feel like, I don't know, antidepressants work for people, I'm not knocking them, whatever works for you, I'm not giving professional help here, but for me it made me feel quite like distant, and a bit like sleepy. So I wrote about this. It was originally called Cruise Control, but yeah, I called it 10 2040. And then yeah, oh, this guitar solo. Depressed pop. Yeah. All right, that was 102040. If you have just joined us, we are streaming my old works. Oh, that sounds weird. So yeah, we're streaming stuff from 2017. So Rena, my first EP. Yes, I know my album is called Sawayama. I'm just lazy, clearly. But yeah, Rena EP came out 2017. It kind of started it all off. It got some really good reviews, and that's how Pixels were born. And so yeah, we are streaming that today, plus some non-album singles. So if you want to join in the chat. Say hello to Pixels. We are a wonderful community of lovely people. So yeah, say hi. Okay. Yeah, it's all on Spotify, obviously. And there is a Spotify playlist underneath this video. So make sure you go check it out. I have obviously put the album under, like, the Sawayama album. So you can go Rena and then, like, non-album singles, then Sawayama. But if you want to know where the sound that you're hearing in Sawayama kind of originated, this is it. Yeah. Cool. Next song is Tunnel Vision featuring Shamir. Oh, Shamir. We love Shamir. Is it going to play? Is she going to play? There she is. There we go. What? Oh my god, XS hit 2 million views. Thank you. Yes. By Arvida Bystrom, who's an amazing Swedish photographer. And kind of the whole EP was really inspired by her, actually. She was doing a lot of art. I guess, like, back in the day, people were like, Tumblr art. But it was that kind of aesthetic, very pastel, kind of like female angst, kind of awkwardness. And yeah, I really enjoyed shooting this video. Literally did this in Arvida's house. Moved her bed. We had a shirt that was, like, empty in the middle, so we, like, put a phone in there. And most of the lighting is actually from a phone, so or a laptop. So you can do anything, guys. If it's your first time listening to this EP, give it some love. Hit like on this video, say nice things in the comments, and make sure you stream it in the link below. Type vocals if you're obsessed with Shamir. Vocals!
Relationships going down the drain. I'm just driven.
So for this song, I was really inspired by D'Angelo and his harmonies, and definitely there's a song that Beyonce did with Luther Vandross called The Closer I Get to You, which is what that singer Shamir is inspired by. I, like, kind of cringe, but I'm kind of into it as well. But, yeah. Cute. And that was Tunnel Vision. Yeah, I don't know what to say. It kind of like one of the, like, I really love that video. I love how simple that song is, and kind of how like sleepy it is. I'm trying to think of any other anecdotes. Thank you for saying it's not cringe. I feel like anything cringe is good. There's so many cringy moments in Sawayama and Rina, but I don't find them cringy. I mean, they're kind of cringy, but like, it's like iconic. FYI, this whole record, so I keep being like, and this is some advice, guys, but this whole record was literally recorded in this room, which is now a standalone studio in my house. But this room was my bedroom, and I was like sleeping, and there was like a tiny desk, and it was like the hottest summer, I remember, when we tried to, when we were finishing this EP. And you can't, I don't know if you like, if you know, you can't like open the window while you're recording. So we were like, me and Clarence were just like sweating. But yeah, again, just very DIY. I think that's kind of what makes this record so special, is that like, it was no expectation, no budget. But I just think it's an amazing, I'm gonna say, I think it's an amazing record. So yeah, you should stream it. Amazing. Cool. Is there any stuff that I need to be reading? No, I think it's fine. Okay. Oh, how did I meet Clarence has been a question that I've been getting. Yeah, kind of like quite unromantic. Like, I met him through management. But funny story is that we had a session, and I was like, oh yeah, also like, if I really want it to like sound really heavy with like some heavy drums and like rocky. And then like Clarence absolutely nailed it, because Alter Life, which I think, is that the next song? No, it's not. Oh my God, time out. Yes. But yeah, we recorded that, and then I was like so freaked out by what he did, because it was like so good, but also like so different to the, because at that point I'd had Where You Are and Tunnel Vision out, and I was like, this is too different. This is kind of what I asked for, but like, calm down. So then I kind of ghosted him for like 3 months or more, I think. And then I remember being like, oh yeah, we should so get in touch with him. And then after that, basically that's, it's a match made in heaven. I'm surprised we haven't killed each other yet, really. We've come very close. No. But yeah, collaborations are so important to everything. Like, I think someone to be like, no, this sounds shit, or this sounds good, or like, you know, push yourself, push each other, is really, really helpful. And also, I don't think without Clarence, I would have like the motivation to do anything, really. Like, he's so fast at what he does. And yeah. Who saw the 1975 cover we did? It was sick. I wish I could just like put it on here, but I can't. I didn't have the visuals lined up. But we did a cover of Love It If We Made It, which is like both of our favorite songs by 1975. You should so go check it out. It's on the Face Magazine's YouTube. And that is like pretty much 85% Clarence Clarity, because I just like did the, I basically just like did the cover. Like, I just recorded the vocals. But yeah, his production is insane in it. So go check it out. Okay, next song is the underrated classic that I like, I don't think I've ever sang this song live, because it's always a minute where I have to like just like outfit change or like take a break on stage. But yeah, this is Time Out. Taking up in my hot air balloon, away, away from you. There ain't no room for justice time. For Time Out. All I needed is just away, 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 I go. See me flying in my spaceship to the moon, away, away from you. Sing it to my own tune, cause baby, all I needed is time. I know that the Beatles are going to be very quiet after this, but that is inspired by Hey Jude. No, not you, Hey Siri. That is cute. That is a cute song. I don't know what else to say about it. It's a cute little interlude. That is an interlude. That is like the length of an interlude. It's like 2 minutes long. Yeah. I feel like a lot of favorite, like people's favorite songs are Time Out. What do you think? Beatles could never. Yes, and it sets up my favorite song ever. It's not my favorite song. Actually, it is my, I don't know, whatever. I have so many favorite songs. But it sets the next song up really well, which is, I can't hear you, Pixels. Beatles has been pretty quiet. Oh my God, New Zealand, it's 5:16 a.m. I'm dead. Thank you for waking up that early. It's Ultra Life. Let's do this. This is a song that Grimes like sent me a DM on Instagram, which like shook me to the core because I'm literally the biggest Grimes fan ever. And she said, "Ultra Life is the best song ever written," or is like best pop song ever written. Shook. Okay, my manager's texting me saying that he wants credit because he said that he's suggested the guitar solo in there. So yeah, everyone type thank you Will in the chat. Shout out House of Us. Okay, guitar solo and key change coming up. Little lyric video for this, which I don't think even has reached 1 million either, but here it is. Again, give it some love, justice. It was a karaoke video actually, and my mum translated it into Japanese. Thank you, mum. What songs do you think deserve a video? Because I think Ultra Life deserves a video, and it makes me sad that she didn't have a proper video. Was you gonna order for a video? Yeah, what song on the EP do you want to see a video from? Not that I don't think it will ever happen, but like, one can dream. One can dream. I know, thanks, Mom. Happy Mom's Day. Obsessed. Yes, we are more than halfway through, actually. I think. Are we? Let me check. Yeah, kinda. Almost. Oh my god, the next one is so underrated. Like, underrated doesn't even cover it because I've only sang this song once at a show. Oh, Justice. Yes, Take Me As I Am, Alter Life. 10-20-40. Oh. Honestly. This sounds like so basic, but I would like. Sorry, that's a bit loud. This sounds so basic, but I would absolutely love to do like a motorcycle Akira highway racing vibe for 10-20-40. That's always what I've had in mind, but what a bummer. We could only dream. Okay, so the next one is like so, like literally so underrated that like it never gets played. I love it. I don't know. Maybe I just feel like it's a bit of a downer in the set, but maybe there should be a bit more downers. Like I said, like I have a problem with like gaps and spaces. I don't have as much of a problem anymore, but now like the set's getting really crowded with a new record and stuff. I'm just like, when are we ever gonna perform that song? But there is there is footage of me playing the song, the next one, which is Through the Wire. And I like lit myself with a phone and I thought it was like super cool. But if you were at the Pickle Factory gig in London, which was my first ever gig, and it was 150 people, and that was an iconic gig, so fun. And that I was like scared shitless. If you see videos of me, I'm literally like, I can't, because I like, again, like expectations up here with the dancing, and then I like set myself loads of choreography to do, and then I just couldn't like focus on anything else, so I'm like stressing out. But if you were there, you're an OG Pixel. Love you so much. Right, next one is Through the Wire. Called Losing a Friend, which is like one of the most amazing songs. Produced this. He also produced Where You Are and Tunnel Vision. So yeah, Stan Hoost. Cute. Yeah. What do you guys think of that interlude? So I got a question about why do I have two interludes in the EP, and God knows why. I never know. It just kind of feels right, but then also I'm just like, why? you know what, interludes are really good for like setting up or like bringing down the mood, or like it can be a BPM thing as well. So if there's like a slow song coming after this, then it's like a really nice segue. Because we went from Old to Life to Through the Wire to CSS. So it's like a nice little curve. It kind of like gives a little support on its way down, rather than it being like, whoa, like what's that? And I kind of like it in Fuck This World, in the new record, Sawayama. Yeah, like that for me is like a really nice like setup for the next song, but it's also like kind of really like making sure that the essence of the song before is like preserved. So yeah, we have come to the end of the EP. And this is the song that I would say that I'm lyrically most proud of in the EP. We stan CSS. Yes, we also have a music video for this as well, which I'm pretty sure hasn't reached 1 million. Justice for Rena EP videos. Yeah. Let me see. Yeah, CSS I'm really happy with, because I feel like I told a story there. And yeah, obviously like inspired little bit at the end as well, and I like that it kind of went to another world, as though like the girl who we're talking about is like living through a different world, which is the internet. So yeah, all right, let's do it. This is the last song of the EP, Cyber Stockholm Syndrome.
Shit out of her straw, ready to go out, only her body tells her no. Pretty but sad inside, isn't she beautiful? Queen of the ball, even when she's home alone. And she said, I'm not here for love tonight. When you touch, just don't feel. Used to feeling things so cold, men in mice and windows, pictures lit by electric lights, fiction, fact, boundaries collide.
Let's go.
Find me in my palm so bright, Cyber Stockholm Syndrome. Can't live on my own, party on my phone, can't live on my own, but I start to feel alone. Better make that so I'll be
produced by Hoost and Clarence Charity, the two worlds combining. I still have that razor phone in my house. So cute. I remember thinking that note, it was really hard to hit. And then like 2 years later, I'm singing that Dynasty solo. Is it growth or am I being stupid?
Oh,
And that was Rina EP. What did you think? Let me know if this was your first time listening to the EP. Because, yeah, this is kind of how I, like, know all of you. And, like, obviously this record is, like, so special to me. And I, like, miss performing this record. It's so fun. So I can't wait to, like, play my new record. Because, I don't know, as a performer, you just, like, don't get the most out of what that song can do for you until you perform it. Like, I love making you sing the Cyber Stockholm bit. Like, it's just so fun. Let me know if you have seen me live before and which city. I really want to know. Okay, should we go straight into the following songs? I feel like we should. Oh my gosh, on 1 millionth time listening, thank you. Okay, so I did a poll on Twitter asking what songs you want played as an extra. So I've got Where You Are, Cherry and Flicker. Those three are definitely being played. But then I asked you guys what else you want me to play. And you all voted for the two songs that I will be playing at the end, plus a little sneaky song for you right at the end. So make sure you stay, because it's very special and a lot of people haven't heard it, I think, if you don't live in a specific country. That's my little hint. All right, next song is, so the song that was released just before STFU, well, it wasn't just, it was like a year before STFU, was Flicker. And again, justice for Flicker. We actually did a little thing with Pixels called hashtag they ain't us. And Flicker is about like people mispronouncing my surname. And kind of it inspired me to write like about how they might flicker, but they won't shine like us. Or people who take the piss out of like uniqueness and anything, and that can be applied to like anything, whether you have a weird name or, you know, you look a bit different, or, you know, whatever people want to pick on you for. So yeah, that was a really sort of special song for me. And weirdly, my voice sounds so low in this, and I was like, yeah, cool, vocal training, my voice is really low now. So I sang this really low, and I kind of think it sounds good, but then at the same time I'm kind of like, whoa. All right, here is Flicker.
These days looking sideways, sadness not from heartache, cold shoulder, the way you look at me. I'm losing my axis, looking at the recess, this pressure, the way you look at me.
Comments saying that Melon should learn. Okay, so Anthony Fantano hasn't yet said my name the way that I would say it. But I think he got loads of like comments from people from his last video where he reviewed Soyoma, which you should totally check out. And so he like DM'd me and was like, oh my god, have I been saying your name wrong the whole time? And I was like, I just thought it was your accent. Oh god, you know what, sometimes you just gotta be like, it's cool, the best intentions, sometimes it's fine. And I was like, it's totally fine. I thought thought it was really jokes. I literally thought it was his accent. A running song. If you're in lockdown and you've chosen running as your sport, I don't know why you have. It's horrible. But if you are, then you should listen to this. It's a nice running. Yeah. Ooh. Oh, love Flickr. I really wanted a proper video for that one, actually. I don't know if we had one planned. Maybe we did. I'm not sure. But yeah, that was Flickr. That was a single before STFU. So as you can imagine, people's surprise when that STFU came out. I guess it's kind of like the end of one era and then the beginning of another era for me with Flickr. I love it. It gets me so happy every time. Hello if you've just joined, by the way. We are streaming my Rina EP from 2017 plus some other singles. Join the Pixel community in the chat. We're all very friendly. And yes, we will be repressing the vinyl this year. I'm sorry, I can't give you anything better. But we're in a lockdown, so it's hard. Let me know if you were like, if you found me through Rina or if you found me through Sawayama. I really want to know. So leave comment in, or you found me through Cherry. Let me know. How's the sound levels for you guys? Is it okay? Give me your cooch. Pixels are the best! Oh, you found me through Channel Vision. Oh my god, so many Rina fans. Valentine. Ooh. Oh my god, sleeping and waking. Is that you, Chester? Chester, get out of the chat. Chester Lockhart, my best friend from LA. Like, I swear is like the only person streaming Sleeping and Waking because every time I get in his car, he plays it. It's just so annoying. There's so many videos of him doing that. Thank you, Spotify. Some people found me through Spotify curated playlist. Woo! Oh, through Fantano. Yay. That's so cool. From where you are. Oh my god, through Pablo Vittar. Yes, love Pablo. Through XS, through Clarence, through a friend. Yes, friend. Chosen family. Oh. STFU. Oh my god, people typing STFU are like getting flagged because it's like people think it's rude. Oh, this is amazing. Oh my god. Okay, yeah, so I was gonna say before we move on to the next one that I will be doing a... What am I doing? Fish, what are you doing? Oh, I'm gonna do reacting to Sawayama reactions for my next video. It won't be a live stream, it'll be pre-recorded for next week's video. But make sure you subscribe because we are putting out videos every single week. Whether it's a music video or a new song or Rina TV or a live stream, there's something for you every week. So tune in, enjoy the community, and let us know what you're thinking. Are you doing well? Okay, so I don't know whether to do this chronologically, whether to do this like hype. Okay. I'm going to play, next song I'm going to play, because I want to wait for Cherry for the song after this, but I'm going to play Where You Are next, because Where You Are is a very special song to me. It's actually a cover of Jackson 5's I Want to Be Where You Are. And that's one of the first songs I like ever produced on GarageBand. It's not, my production is not in the final, but it was like my demo. And I wrote it on GarageBand. And yeah, Hoost produced that one. So shout out Hoost, I am. And that video, we have a video for that as well. So I'll put that in. All right. This is Where You Are. Yeah. Supremacy. Definitely want to share the demo, but honestly, trying to find the masters, like the actual files for these, were quite hard, so I actually had to download them from iTunes. So I don't know if I'll be able to find the demo, babes. I will try. Honestly, so I downloaded myself on iTunes. Was actually shot by Ali Kerr, who directed the STFU video as well, and also the XS video, and also another video. So we've done four videos together. And this was actually her bedroom that we dressed. We like ripped out this planetarium book, put it on the wall. That Alone Together book, which I was obsessed with, and it was big inspiration for this EP. You should read it. It's by Sherry Turkle. Very iconic. Oh yeah, good shout. Yes, and Namjoon from BTS RM shared this song, and it went number one on Naver. And I was like, oh my god, BTS know who I am. So then I met BTS behind, in the backstage in O2, and that was iconic. It was so nice. RM was gorge, lovely person. Guitar solo coming up. Yes, I did not play this. Where You Are. I think that came out in like 2016, I want to say. 2016, maybe. That is wild. Yeah, I had no eyebrows. That was like just when I went blonde as well. Like, it's like honey blonde. And then we kind of went a little bit over the top with the old bleach in the brows. So I look like a granddad, but it's all good. I think it's fashion. Oops, wrong one. But yeah, what do you think of that video? Have you ever seen the Where You Are video? I don't know, it's kind of pop. I don't know, I saw the Where You Are is kind of popping off on YouTube at the moment. But weird. But this video, I remember me and, well, Ali was starting out as a filmmaker. I was starting out as a musician. And she was like, we could not get any budget to like get a camera. But then she had a job like on the Monday and then called me on the Friday, was like, we managed to get the gear sent over to us for the weekend. Shall we shoot this video you want to shoot? So then we ended up shooting it. And so we got a red camera for free. Gorgeous. We love to see it. And yeah, we shot that whole thing. We had a dolly in the house and like slow-mo and doing that whole and tassels. We just bought everything from like Tiger and made it happen. And yeah, I think we literally shot that video for like 500 quid. So very proud of that. Yeah, I don't know. Are you guys enjoying this like little behind the scenes tea? I've just got like so many little memories about like this era and how like everything seemed like a struggle, but kind of at the same time, it's like the most fun because there's kind of nothing to lose at that point. Yes, affordable coin. Okay, so we have three more songs plus one that I'm going to throw in there because I love you guys. Yeah, this is my coming out song. So I am bisexual, pansexual. And yeah, I came out with this song. Was it 2018, I think? Yeah, I love this song so much. It's very much inspired by City Pop. And yeah, we stan Cherry. And here is Cherry.
Hello.
Again, like a cringy moment. Again, he produced most of it, and then Clarence Clarity also additionally produced the track as well. And in the morning of the session that I wrote this song, there was a girl on the train. She gave me a little look. I want to say female gaze, but that's what the girl gaze is about. And yeah, it inspired me to write. And the song is kind of about shame and how I feel like sometimes being bisexual, like if you're in a heterosexual relationship and you're not like validly bisexual, and I had a battling a lot of bi erasure, so that's kind of what the song is about, but also celebrating that as well. Oh, and the video. love that song so much. It actually genuinely makes me emotional. Wow. You know what actually makes me emotional is that I was really quite afraid of releasing this song. And when I did release this song, it was the incredible DMs and messages I got from you guys about your own experience with your own sexuality. Oh, I can't even like talk about it. Oh my gosh. And those were so touching, and it really actually spurred me on to like, with this record, with Sawayama as well, to like write authentically, write your truth, write stuff that's not been written. Everyone's heard a heterosexual love story before, and that's great. We all grew up on it. I love that too. I still listen to music that talk about heterosexual love. I mean, I'm not condemning it. But at the same time, I love telling these stories that haven't been told before. And yeah, thank you so much. If you found me through Cherry, I love you. I hope you're doing well. And yeah. Yeah, gay rights, LGBTQ plus rights. Okay, we have a couple more songs left. So you guys chose two songs. You chose Valentine, which was actually a single that was released by 88 Rising. So I did one single with 88 Rising. And yeah, I mean, we released it on Valentine's Day. It was like an anti-Valentine song. But you guys voted for it on Twitter. We did a poll and you guys voted for Valentine. So yeah, we are going to play Valentine now. Go. There we go. Clarity produced this one. So sick, actually. I haven't listened to this in ages. This vibe and just like my music in general, I recommend you go listen to Clarence Garrity. He's the main producer that I work with and he is insane, so search Clarence Garrity. The production on this is insane. What the hell? Oh my god. Okay, yeah, that is pretty special. I honestly haven't listened to this in so long. Valentine is a song I'm really scared of because, oh my god, wait, that's not why I'm scared of it. Completely different tangent. But Ariana Grande fans, I love Ariana, but Ariana Grande fans like ripped Valentine and then like put it like on Twitter to make people think that it was part of Sweetener, which is jokes and very much flattering because like Ariana's voice is incredible. So that's a little fun thing from Valentine there. But Chester, shut up. Chester Lockhart in the chats, everyone, because she has woken up. She's in LA. She's woken up to say hello just in time for the next song, which is my debut single, actually, like ever, like the first ever song that I released ever. And it's good, but like it's from 2013. And yeah, this is a very special song. I'm not slagging it off. I think it's great. Oh yeah, it was like, yeah, the Valentine was NASA demo. Play Sleeping. Okay, do you guys want Sleeping and Waking? I need to see you all write Sleeping and Waking, my debut single, in the chat if you want to hear it. Because that was the second top one in the poll that we did on Twitter of the non-album singles that we'll play. And Sleeping and Waking, Chester. Ah! Oh my god. We stan Sleeping and Waking. We stan Sleeping and Waking. Okay. You asked. We are delivering. Here is my debut single from 2013, Sleeping and Waking. Did you know that there is a music video to Sleeping and Waking that has about 100,000 views? Here it is. Check out my Can I Speak to the Manager haircut. Legendary photographer Jack Davison shot this because we're still really good friends, but we were like babies, like 20 something years old. Yeah, he kindly shot an amazing video for me. Thank you, Jack Davison. We start. Was a year after Cambridge. Yeah, I graduated in 2012. This was, yes, 2013. Right, fresh after college. I won't forget. Who's produced this? actually. I love it. It's got like a weird like triplet vibe. So good. Chester, I hope you're happy. Your propaganda has helped. Chester Lockhart, I hope you're happy. Genuinely, I explained this before, but if you've just joined us, hello, we are streaming Rena EP, my first debut EP, body of work. And plus, we just played my first ever debut single from 2013, which Chester, my best friend, has been nagging me to play. So yeah. Okay, we are gonna move forward. What do you think of Sleeping and Waking? Justice for Sleeping and Waking. Give her that love. Give that video some love, because she's sad. She's sitting at under 100,000 views. Streamer for not Karen's rights. I'm dead. So I said that will be the last song, but I couldn't resist, because there is a song that is a Sawayama bonus track for Japan that has not been internationally released, because it's a Japan exclusive, guys. I can't help it. You guys are just gonna have to get it somewhere, okay? But I'm gonna play it because I love you, and I want the worldwide pixels, not just the people who are in Japan, to have a little chance of hearing this song, which I wrote in, I think we wrote this, me and Host wrote this in 2015. So, yeah, and it's got some gibberish Japanese. I'm so sorry if you're Japanese and listening to these lyrics. They're awful. I can't believe I just said my lyrics are awful. But it's not my proudest moment. It was written in 2015. I'm proud of the song, but sometimes your lyrics don't pop off. Anyway, I'm just going to play it before I get in trouble. This is the Japanese exclusive song for Sawayama. This is the bonus track for Japan. This is Tokyo Takeover. So hardcore demonetized because it's just what happens, really. But I got it remonetized, and also now the playback is available in all countries. So. Concludes our listening party. Did you guys like Tokyo Takeover? I hope you enjoyed it, because it'll probably get taken down because it's a Japanese exclusive for the Japanese fans. But yeah, let me know what you thought. Yes, on Pepper Push It vibes. Oh my god, Chester, you are literally tearing up the chat. I cannot. I miss you so much. Does anyone else miss their friends? Loads. I miss my friends so much. Okay, well, I'm going to go back to the main screen now, and then I'm going to answer some more questions, and then we're going to wrap up, but I'm going to answer some more questions. Okay, let me try take it back to the main screen. And we're back. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what you thought of this Rina streaming party. I loved it. What is your favorite song? Is it from the Rina EP? Is it from the Nobound singles? Is it from Sawayama? Stream Sawayama. I have a little playlist underneath. That is all the songs that we featured today, except Tokyo Takeover, obviously. Don't tell anyone that we played that. But yeah, I've had so much fun chatting to you. Let me grab some more questions so I can... Okay. Oh my god, I'm so indecisive. I've kind of answered a lot of these. Okay, hang on. So, would you ever remix one of the songs, or is the Rina era over? It kind of is. I'm sorry, but it is. But the Sawayama season has just begun. So stream Sawayama in the description. Also, my merch is in the description box. Everything is in the description box below. Make sure you are subscribed and like this video. I'm a YouTuber. Okay, Sawayama has a very different feel from Rina. Which era are you planning on taking the new sound, I think? I don't know yet. I don't know, I haven't written new songs since the record came out, because I think you just need a bit of like a sort of purging period where you're just like, okay, and that is done. And you know what would have been, I mean, I feel very inspired by touring, because like hearing the songs being played and like what the response is to it can be really like helpful and inspiring, but obviously we can't do that for a while, so yeah. I don't know. I mean, I'm kind of really into country pop crossover at the moment, very stripped down music. But as always, I'll be just honing in on pop songwriting and just, you know, collaborating with Clarence, I'm sure. Cool. This is a cute question. What does all the support for your music mean for the future of your career? More tours, more music. I love you. I love you too. That is such a sweet question. I cannot stress enough how grateful I am. I wake up every single day. I'm so grateful that you guys even bother to listen to my music. It is just beyond comprehension. We actually just reached 2 million monthly listeners on Spotify, which is insane. We were on like 200,000 when we released STFU, and now like, it's really wild. So thank you so much. And yes, just more stuff, more music, more everything, more shows, hopefully when this is all lifted, and more content like this. Let me know if you're enjoying Rena TV, because I love making them, but I sometimes feel a little bit like Carol Baskin. Like, hey cool cats and kittens, this is Carol Baskin from Big Cats Rescue. But yeah, I really hope you're enjoying it. And let me know any like suggestions for future videos, because this video was your suggestion, so this is why we did it. But next week, actually, we will be doing a reaction to the reactions to So I Am Her as part of Rena TV. So that won't be live streamed, but it'll be like pre-recorded. Would you say your EP and your debut album are two opposites, or are they connected narratively in some way? Love you so much. Love you too. I would say connected. I would say it's an evolution. But at the same time, it's like so different. I feel like I'm in a much more confident place when I wrote Sawayama. It's completely different, because when I was writing Rena, there was almost like, I didn't feel like there was any expectation really. And it was kind of one of the things I kind of used to do, which is a really bad habit and you shouldn't do it. But I used to listen to Rena while I was writing Sawayama and think, oh, I could never like write anything like this. And I would like completely beat myself up about it. And so, I would say they're both very different in a really good way. And I've loved playing it today, because it just reminded me where we came from, Pixels. Okay. When did I get into music production? Was it difficult in the beginning? Love you from the Middle East. Love you. When you mean music production, does it like, I'm guessing you just, maybe you mean like on the whole. I do produce the music, but in a way I kind of really refrain from saying that, because basically I like don't know how to physically like do the things I want to hear. So I'm not like on, like if Clarence is there, I'm not on Ableton at the same time doing it. But I'm in every single session and I'm bringing ideas and sounds, and I'll like get a certain idea and then I'll send it over to him, see what he thinks, and then you know we're constantly riffing, or I'll be in a session with an engineer, engineers are a little bit different to producers, and we'll be sifting through loads of tracks and you know picking the right thing for the track, but I guess in that way I have produced from the beginning, because I've been heavily invested in what the final track sounds like, so I'm there pretty much every step of the process. There's some bits where Clarence is like, where I'm just going to take this and just clean it up, clean the session up, clean this, you know, add a little bits to this. But on the whole, like I'm there at every session, even if we're not writing something new, if we're working on the track and just making sure that the sound is consistent and there's music and beats and inspirations that I want in there. And yeah, so it's been from the beginning, I would say. This is an interesting one. Do I plan to release an album in Japanese? I said this before. If there's someone who translates it for me, I would do it. I would sing it. But I don't think I'm a very good writer of the Japanese language. Even though I'm fluent in it, like I can speak like fluent Japanese, but writing is a completely different thing. Can I perform Tokyo Takeover on tour? I don't know. Look, I'm telling you, Sawayama, the album takes up literally takes up an hour to perform. And like my sets are an hour long. So we have to like shave down bits and we want to put in some edits and stuff. So it's a bit tricky, but we will see. I don't know. I know that the Japanese physical release has been pushed back a little bit just because I think they're going into lockdown right now, so it's a bit like tricky. But hold tight, if you have made a pre-order on Amazon and or any retailer in Japan, they will be sent to you, don't worry. It's just a bit of a delay. It's a global delay, darling. Okay. Interesting question. Why isn't Cherry on Sawayama and Where You Are on Rina? So there's two reasons. Where You Are wasn't on Rina because I think there was a big gap between them. I don't know. Also, okay, so Cherry wasn't on Sawayama for two reasons. I don't think it was way too in the past for it to make sense. And also because of like amazingness of Spotify and you can make your own playlist by like adding Cherry into like whatever album you want. I was like, okay, well, cool. There's no way that people are like going to miss out on things. So I was like, it should be fine. But also there were two different labels. So Cherry was released by Pias and then Sawayama was released by Dirty Hit. So it can get a bit complicated there as well. But main reason is it just did not fit for me. And I think that if you listen to Sawayama, which you should stream Sawayama from the beginning to the end, you will know that I don't think it sonically fits. Oh, this is fun. How was filming Vivo Discover? Cherry and Tamia Zan performances are amazing. Thank you. Have you seen the Vivo Discover performances? They're really great. We will chuck them in the playlist as well, but those were fun. Yes, bisexual lighting. We love to see it. It was like pink, blue, and red. Is that the point? Yeah, that's it, isn't it? Oh my God, my brain. I cannot. I'm telling you. Like lockdown has like made my brain melt. But yeah, it was so fun. They're very like amazing. I remember it was like I was wearing a latex, like everything was latex and I was sweating so much. Oh my God, it was quite disgusting. I'm gonna do two more questions, guys, and I'm gonna have to head off me. Since quarantine, have you worked on new music or have you taken the time to learn something new about yourself or just anything? I haven't written any new music since quarantine. I find it much easier to kind of write and produce with other people. So I haven't written anything. I should. I feel really guilty about it. Hang on. I'm just looking at some of your comments.
There's like two school of thoughts, I think, with the lockdown. People who are saying, oh, you know, you need to learn something, like be proud of this the time that you spent during lockdown. But also at the same time, I think it's like, it's kind of really crazy right now. It's okay to just like check out a little bit and kind of watch the world go by. But saying that, I think I've just been getting into life this setup, doing this, these visuals. These graphics and these stickers. So I've been getting like really nerdy about that. And cooking loads. What about you guys? What have you guys been up to during quarantine, during lockdown? Essex loves you. Yes, I love Essex. Cool. So maybe, do I say one more or do I say two more? Oh my God. Oh, this is a good question. Why did I decide to make Rina an EP instead of my debut album? Well, we kind of said it was a debut mini album because I don't know, I didn't really like connect to the word like EP at the time. So I think we said it was a debut mini album, which is a really normal thing to say about EPs in Japan. But I don't know if it's like as common. But yeah, I don't know. I just felt like I wanted to put an EP out before an album. Yeah, I don't really have a great answer to that actually. It feels like an EP. Two interludes and eight songs feels like an EP. What do you think? All right, I'm gonna do one more question. Oh, what's lagging? Are things lagging? Oh, weird. Ah. Are we good? I think we're back on track. Oh no, it is lagging. Okay, well, I think, I don't know, my computer's probably going crazy. It's says I have excellent connection to the streaming. Maybe it's my software. Okay, never mind. I have one more question anyway. Oh, whoops. Okay. Have you changed much since the Rena EP to the recent Saima release in terms of self-expression, self-awareness? Yes, so much. And I think you guys have really helped in that. You guys supporting the non-album singles, the EP has really helped become really confident in kind of listening to my gut instinct about what I want to write about. So yeah, I'm really, really grateful for that. And yeah, I think also age gives you that lovely little confidence boost that you really need. And I feel very lucky. Oh, it's like lagging. Sorry. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. I have really enjoyed listening to the EP with you. It's been an absolute pleasure. Thank you so much for tuning in. And make sure you're subscribed. Make sure you check out the links in the description so you can listen to the playlist and take yourself back into that moment where you first heard this EP. Or if you enjoyed what you've heard and this is your first time, then make sure you check it out and get acquainted. But yeah. I love you so much. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I will see you soon.